What is the Iowa gambling task? Allow me to illustrate this for you. Okay, you have a participant. He is sitting in front of a computer screen. This is what he sees. He sees a virtual representation of four decks of playing cards. And then he sees these two bars up here. One is green, one is red. Now this red bar represents how much cash the participant is given at the beginning of the game. Now, here's the trick. Most research studies will give them monopoly money. Okay, not real money, but monopoly money. All right? So you're getting basically fake money. But if you're lucky enough to get into some of these research studies, some of them, a rare few, will actually give you real life money. Wow! Okay, so hopefully you'll be one of those rare few that will get into a research study where they start actually giving you real life cash. Don't count on it though. Anyway, so this is what you see. Now in this particular research study, we're going to presume they're giving them monopoly money instead of real money. So you've got $2,000 worth of monopoly money right off the bat. Now then, what you're supposed to do is you're supposed to pick cards out of these four decks. You could, all you do is you hover your mouse over a particular pile of cards, and when you click it, you've actually picked a card. Okay? Now sometimes when you pick a card, you'll win money. Okay? Say you clicked on this particular deck right here, a card turns over, and you win $40. So now you got $2,040. Okay? Now then, sometimes you'll click on a deck like this, the card will turn over and it'll say, you've won $100, but now you've lost 30. Well, you're still $70 ahead, so now you got $2,070. Get the picture? Now sometimes you'll pick a card, you say you click on this thing right here, it'll say you won $50, but then it'll turn around and say, but now you've lost $100. So now you've lost more than you actually won. So now you're at $1,950. See what I mean? Now you continue to pick cards out of these decks until such time as the computer says you have to stop. It would be nice if you could pick every single card out of every single deck, but they won't let you do that. At a certain point, there's a timer on it, it shuts off. Now the goal is, you're supposed to not only retain the $2,000 you're given right off the bat, but also you're to get as much money over and above the $2,000 as you can possibly get before the computer stops you. Now here's the key. Some of these decks of cards have better cards than the others. Okay. Let's say we have deck C and deck D. Now you pick a card out of deck C and you win $50 and you don't lose anything. Okay. You pick a card out of deck D. Okay, let's say you pick a card out of deck D. So that card wins you $25 but costs you $50. Well, are you going to continue picking cards out of deck D? Absolutely not. You'll start picking cards out of deck C. Because that at least wins you money and doesn't lose you anything. And maybe if you continue to pick out of this thing, it will continue to win you money without you losing anything. It'll win you bigger amounts of money too. Say the first time you pick it, and it wins you only $50. The next time you pick a card out of there, it wins you $100. And say, the next time you pick a card out of there, it wins you $300. Well, you're going to want to keep picking out of deck C because it's winning you more and more money. And it's not losing you anything. See what I mean? So like I said, when the whole thing stops, then not only are you supposed to be able to maintain the $2,000 you were given at the beginning of the game, but you're also supposed to show a profit beyond that. And if you do, you're a pretty smart cookie. If you aren't, well, there you go. Anyway, if you have any comments or questions on this, go ahead and leave them down in the comments below. I will tell you more in a future video. Stay tuned.